Good day and welcome to my channel again. I want to use this opportunity and thank everybody that watched my last video. I know it was bad though. It was bad, but thanks for watching it. Those that commented, those that subscribed, those that liked the videos, thank you. So I've come to episode 2 of this my video again. Today we are going to talk about bleeding. If you are bleeding, what should you do? And what should you not do? Steps to take when you are bleeding. But the bleeding for small cuts and wounds, stuff like that, like small cuts like this one I have on my palm here, yes, or any this one here, small cuts like that. So what do you need to do when you have small cuts and wounds? First, you need to put your hand in the running water. Let's take for example, you are cutting vegetables or onions or anything, and then you cut your hand. You just put your hand under a running water, either tap or anything, just running water. Then you apply direct pressure. You either apply direct pressure with your finger on that side, or you can use cotton wool, sterile cotton, for applying the direct pressure. When you apply the direct pressure, you elevate. The blood that, the artery that circulates blood to the hand is the axillary artery around here, and then the brachial artery. So the artery comes downwards, elevating the site of injury is going to reduce the force of blood to that area. If it's the leg, if it's to be on your leg, you can put it horizontally or vertically too to reduce the flow of blood to that area. When you apply pressure and you elevate, the next thing you need to do is to apply cold compress. Okay, for homeostasis to occur, what you have the body does is that it starts by constricting the blood vessels, the tip of the blood vessels that were cut, so that the force of blood there will be reduced and to get the necessary materials you need to carry out the blood clotting factor. So applying cold compress is going to be a mechanical way to cause constriction of the blood vessels around the site of injury. So applying, when you apply the cold compress for like 5 to 10 minutes, homeostasis is supposed to have occurred at that point. Homeostasis is supposed to occur at that point. So when it occurs, like from 5 to 10 minutes, then you know that your vitamin K level in your blood is normal. But if in 5 to 10 minutes the blood is still flowing, my dear, go and meet your doctor, because your vitamin K level may be really low or you have other blood problems. So the next thing you need to do is, after the blood stop, then you now wash your hands. Yes, you wash your hands. When you wash your hands, you check the site of injury, if there's any debris inside. Take for example, your child may be playing outside and fall. Sure, there may be some sand that or minor stones that is lodged inside the wound, or even cutting vegetable. The vegetable may stay there too. Who knows? So you need to wash your hand again, clean with the surrounding mild soap. Do not allow soap to enter into the wound. Do not allow soap to enter into the wound. Good. After doing all this, you cover with clean bandage. In fact, non-adhesive bandage is advised, like the one that has the cotton in the center and then just the tape by the side. That's what I excuse. By the side. Good. Now, these are the things you're supposed to do. Apply direct pressure, use cold compress, and cover with bandage. You can also apply petroleum jelly before putting the bandage on top. There are things you are not supposed to do. What are those? Do not use hydrogen peroxide to clean the wound. Hydrogen peroxide is meant for very, very dirty wounds. It removes the energy from the oxygen, from the flesh around. So using hydrogen peroxide for the wound at this point is going to kill the life tissues that are found around there. So do not use hydrogen peroxide and iodine. Do not use tourniquet. So tourniquet is any object that can be used, or any material that is used to tie a particular part of your body to stop the blood flow to a particular place. Take for example, for this my cut that is on my palm here, I tie a tourniquet, maybe I carry a cloth or rope and tie it on my arm here, which stops the blood flow to the palm. It's not advised. In fact, when using tourniquet is the last resort. It's in place where my major arteries have been cut, that is arteries or veins. For small cuts like this, maybe just the capillaries or the arterioles have been cut. So for big cuts like arteries and veins, that's when you can use the tourniquet to prevent excess loss of blood, because just at that pressure won't work on it. The tourniquet note is only used for 10 minutes, nothing more than 10 minutes. And as we said, it's first aid, so it's something that is being done quickly before it's getting very professional help in the hospital. Do not use sand or grass to stop your blood. Most individuals, if blood pour in their hand, if they have cut themselves, they will go and find sand to pour in it. Please do not pour sand on it. The sand is very dirty. Millions of microbes are found inside. Yes, so they can infect the wound. By the way, the wound is a sterile place, so you need to maintain a sterility. Good. You need to maintain a sterility. So do not use sand and do not use grass. By the way, prevention is better than cure. If your child is going out to go and play, make sure you give him, cover his legs. You can give him hand gloves, kneecap. You can use, put the glove in there for the kneecap. That place is going to prevent, is going to safeguard the child in case of wounds and anything. So these are the things you need to do when you have bleeding from minor cuts. So this video is for those that have bleeding in minor cuts. So those people that they pierce them dagger, please, this thing is not going to work for you 100%. Go directly to the hospital. But this is in case of any home injury or cuts. When your child is cutting vegetable, please be with them there, because they may start doing rough play with the knife. Yes, and this may lead to cutting of one person or one part of the body or another. So for this is the end. For this episode, this is the end about bleeding. Next episode, I'm going to be talking about bones. Yes, bones. How to deal with bone? Maybe oil, fire, water. Yes, water, hot water, bone. So I'm going to be discussing how you're going to deal with them. Thank you if you've watched up to this point. I love you. Please continue to like, share, and comment. And subscribe, please, for more videos. Thanks once again. I love you. Bye-bye.